Hey everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is this crown braid hairstyle. This is one of my very favorite hairstyles to wear during the summer because it's a great heatless hairstyle. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you're new or if you haven't yet, and let's begin. For this style, I've got my part on the right side, and then I'm just going to create a zigzag part down the back of my head to divide my hair into two sections, a left side and a right side. Then I'm just going to clip away the hair on the right side. Now with the hair on the left side, I'm going to divide out a section of hair to frame my face. Then I'm going to pick up a section near the hairline to start my braid. So I'm dividing this into three smaller pieces, and I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand for the first stitch of the braid. Then I'm going to cross the right strand under the middle and start incorporating new sections into the braid. So I'm picking up a piece and crossing it under the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the left strand under the middle strand, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under the middle strand as well. So once more, I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under and into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the left strand under the middle, picking up a new section and crossing it under the middle strand as well. So I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing to braid the hair on this side of my head in a Dutch braid. And as I braid, I just want to make sure to keep this braid lower on my head, closer to my ear, because we're going to wrap the other braid above this one, so keeping this one lower will help the braids lay more smoothly together. Now once I've added all of the hair from this side of my head into the braid, I'm just going to continue braiding the section in a regular 3-strand braid, and then secure the bottom with 2 bobby pins so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to let down the hair on the right side that I clipped away, and I'm just going to repeat the same steps and braid this section into a second Dutch braid. So again, I'm picking up a section near the part, dividing it into 3 smaller pieces, and I'm going to start by crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and then begin incorporating new sections into the braid. And as I'm braiding, I'm going to make sure to keep this braid a little bit higher on my head because the braid from the left side is going to be wrapped and pinned underneath this braid. So I just want to make sure to create a space for the braids to lay smoothly next to each other. So then once I've added all of the hair in from this side of my head, you just want to continue braiding the section down to the ends in a regular 3-strand braid, and then secure the bottom with bobby pins so it doesn't unravel. Once both braids are done, I'm just going to spray the hair with hairspray, and then I'm going to go back over each braid and gently pull on the edges. This will make the braids look wider and more full. This is an extra step, and you can skip this if you like to keep your braids nice and tight, but I like to make my braids look as big as I can, and this will also help hide any gaps in between the two braids once they are pinned in place. So then once I've pulled them apart a little bit, I'm just going to take the braid from the left side of my head and wrap it underneath the right braid. Then I'm going to slide some bobby pins into the middle of the braid, pushing them along the length of the braid, and this will pin the braid against my head while also hiding the bobby pins underneath the hair. And then I'm just going to pin down the ends of the braids at the top of my head, removing the bobby pins that were at the end of the braid. Then I'm going to do the same thing with the braid on the right side, and this one I'm going to lay along the top of the left braid, pinning the braid down the middle to hide the pins underneath, and then use more bobby pins to secure the end of the braid at the top of my head.
So that wraps up today's video. Make sure to click the thumbs up if you want to see more heatless hairstyles like this one. And make sure to subscribe to my channel if you're new or if you haven't yet. That way you won't miss out on any future videos. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.